The police officer has been charged with domestic violence, and it's not the first time he's been accused of breaking the law. Luis Nunez is currently suspended for his role in a towing kickback scheme, and now he's accused of assaulting his wife inside their Baltimore home. 11 News reporter Carrie Cavanaugh has more.
Luis Nunez, a Baltimore City police officer, posed for this mugshot Thursday night after he was arrested for domestic violence. According to court documents, Nunez's wife called 911 after he, quote, accused her of cheating on him and became upset because of a text message. Mr. Nunez then slapped Mrs. Nunez twice on the left side of her head and grabbed her by the hair, end quote. Police booked the 34-year-old Nunez on second-degree assault. The 5-year city police veteran has been suspended from the department since February when he was implicated in a towing kickback scheme along with 16 fellow officers.
I personally took the badges from every one of those men who were arrested.
Nunez pled guilty to federal extortion charges and is awaiting sentencing in the towing case. He's the latest of several local law enforcement officers accused of domestic violence. Brian Eaton of Baltimore County was charged with assaulting his ex-girlfriend, a fellow officer, last week. In June, former D.C. Detective Richmond Phillips was charged with killing his estranged girlfriend and her baby. Dorothy Lenig advocates for battered women at the House of Ruth. She says women abused by police officers are often reluctant to seek help.
So this is somebody who carries a gun, who knows where the domestic violence shelter is.
Lenig adds that while an aggressive attitude may lend itself to police work, it can backfire at home.
They come home and that you can't put that aside. You want to call the shots at home. And if you believe, again, that you get to be in charge and be in control, if something isn't going the way you want, then the reaction can be violence.
Of his badge and weapon when he was arrested back in February, he faces up to 20 years in prison for that federal extortion case. Reporting downtown, I'm Carrie Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.